witch hunt, hinahanap ko yung 82 million.
Writer, PH, Studios.
Pag-usapan natin yung funding sa FAP. Kasi ang funding ng FAP ang gagaling lang naman talaga sa Metro Manila Film Festival. Funds. Okay? The 10% of the amusement tax, pinagkahatian yon ng 5 agency. Okay, Mobile Fund, Anti-Piracy, Optical Board, FTCP, and FAP. And we only get 20% of that. Okay. So, last year, nung pumupo ako, kasi when I was talking to, nung nag-turn over sa akin si Leo Martinez, nagdemanda siya sa MMDA kasi there was about 82 million uncollected proceeds na dapat mapunta sa FAP. So sabi ko sa kanya gano'n, what happened to that? Sabi ko gano'n, ano nangyari dun sa kaso mo? Tapos gumano lang siya. Sabi ko, what do you mean gano'n? Nag-shrug lang siya. So what does it mean? Ano yung gano'n? So he did not answer me. So I have to find out. So nagpunta ako sa MMDA, that courtesy call, and we sat down with the General Lim and some of the mga officers in charge of the Metro Manila Film Festival, and I asked, sabi kong gano'n, ano po yung nangyari dun sa dapat supposed to be collection namin from MMDA dun sa Metro Manila Film Funds? Sabi nila, naibigay na namin. So sabi ko, can I ask at least a document that will say that we are paid, di ba? So wala pang napapakita sa akin up to now. Ang sinasabi naman sa akin ng FAP from before, wala naman daw talaga silang nakokollect na. At nakita ko naman doon sa mga documents nila, wala silang nakokollect na. So who's telling the truth? I mean, my experience with MMDA, kasi si Leo Martinez was kicked out eh. Nakick out siya sa board eh, na supposed to be doon sa Metro Manila Film. And then I think last year or early on this year, ang nakick out naman si Lisa Dino, FTCP, nakick out din siya. So, my experience, ito lang, you know, it's not a complaint, but, you know, I'm just saying the facts. From December till now, ang natatanggap lang namin is 2.7 million. How can I run a film academy? How can I run an agency with a 2.7 million budget? Nothing. So, even with this Luna, I was talking to MMDA kasi marami nagsasabi sa akin, Vivian, huwag mo na ituloy yan because first of all, wala kang budget. Second, it's pandemic. So I was even considering that because when I was trying to reach out with MMDA, kasi may collectibles na kami and we don't even know how much we're supposed to collect kasi wala naman sila pinapakita. Okay, this is the gross. This is what you're supposed to receive. Wala kami natatanggap na gano'n. So where is the statement of account? How much are we supposed to get, right? But my admin kasi medyo resourceful siya. He was able to just take a picture of what we were supposed to get. So alam ko meron pa kaming collectibles about 2 million yan now. So sabi ko gano'n, kasyang-kasya yan for our Luna Awards and all. And also to give incentives kasi sabi ko, what's the use of, giving awards? Sabi nga nila nung araw eh, hindi naman naisasanla yun, di ba? So, but of course, it has other purpose, no, why we give out awards. And I think it's very important too. But then, so marami nagsabi sa akin, no, you have to continue with awards night to give moral booster kasi because of what is happening now in the industry na talagang kumbaga it was set aside. What made me decide to continue with Luna Awards is when somebody told me, alam mo Vivian, maraming nagugutom na tao starving because of the pandemic. Entertainment industry ka lang. Hindi kayo importante at this point. That's when my got me boiling because look, sabi kong gano'n, nung nag-lockdown tayong lahat at ikinulong tayo lahat sa bahay natin, ano ang ginawa ng mga tao? Hindi ba nanood ng pelikula, nanood ng television? It was the entertainment industry. industry that saved us from our insanity. So, I mean, wag mo sabihin na entertainment industry lang kami because we are a content provider industry. Without us, sabi kong gano'n, na-entertain ba ang tao? Sabi kong gano'n. So, that got me going because sabi kong gano'n, gano'n lang ang tingin nila sa atin, di ba? And then the industry, at saka yung industry natin, nagugutom. Ang daming film workers na nagugutom eh. Ang daming namang kumakapit dito eh, di ba? As a worker, di ba? So they cannot just say, you are just an entertainment industry. Therefore, you know, we don't care about you. Parang gano'n eh.
Pero pwede bang malaman kung sino nagsabi mo?
Wag na.
Hindi yung 82 million na missing without document, without any statements whatsoever, it should be an issue with MMFF and not with anyone else.
Correct. It was ano ah, that was audited by COA. It was COA who said, guys, fact, meron kayong uncollected 82 million from MMDA. You know, it was not just an imagination on our, on well, the previous FAP, na meron silang 82 million. So, I'm on a witch hunt. Hinahanap ko yung 82 million, kung nasaan yung 82 million. But, you know, the thing is, they have to realize na ang Metro Manila Film Festival was made and was conceived and was practiced for many years. It's because it's for the film workers. Diba? Yes. Kaya tayo nagkakaroon ng Metro Manila Film Festival. Mm-hmm. It's because it is for the film workers. Mm-hmm. So ngayon, kung na-shortchange ang mga film workers, I have to say something about it because that's my job. Diba? Mm-hmm. Kaya nga ako nilagay rito siguro. Sabi ko nga, what was the criteria on why you're putting me here? Siguro,
what legal action are you taking to collect the 82 million?
Meron na nagkaroon eh. Nagkaroon na ng legal action and that is what I am trying to find out from Leo Martinez and I'm just getting a shrug. No?
Okay.
So, I will find out. I mean, you know, I'm trying to still talk to MMDA about it. But as of now, kasi wala naman din kami communication. I tried to email them about my collections, even my collections of something I cannot even get. What more is the 82 million? So I don't know. Yung 82 million naman, nangyari yon nung panahon ni Bayani Fernando. And then nag-crossover kay Tolentino. And then from Tolentino, and then yata yung kay, ano na, ngayon, kay General Tim.
Patib yan, Patib.
Yeah.
One follow-up question. Yung 82 million accumulated through how many years?
I think it was from 2000, let me, ano, I have a note. From 2002 to 2008.
But din yung finalo up every year. Di sana hindi umabot ng ganong malaking.
Well, si Leo, in fairness to him, he nag-file siya ng suit noong 2014. Nagdemanda siya. Dinemanda niya ang MMDA. Aside from the legal point of view, because it's COA who was saying that you have an uncollected proceeds, siguro ngayon it's my chance. I mean, guys, you know, I am sure it's going to be in the newspaper or whatever. I mean, sabi ko nga, I talked to the management of FAP. I said, you know, is it okay for me to really talk about this? Kasi I think we've exhausted all means of communications with MMDA. And syempre, mahirap din, di ba? Mahirap din naman. Sana if we can do it amicably or even talk about it. Pero dead end, eh. You know, even sana yung counting collections namin for this year. Can you imagine it's already December? Yung first tranche nung supposed to be matatanggap namin was natanggap namin ng June. E-collected na yon nung 2019 pa yon, di ba? So nung June lang namin natanggap yung first tranche. And those proceeds, supposed to be, dapat yon binibigay ka agad kung sino yung mga recipients. And yeah. I just don't understand why. So I think it's really, somebody has to know. I mean, I have to say it. I have to tell the people kasi otherwise, baka sabihin ng mga tao, eh bakit mo kinukondom? Bakit hindi ka nagsasalita? Diba? So, you know, I have to say something.